Hi everyone, it's me, Darlene. I am here with block three for March, quilt block of the month. And I'm excited about this one. I didn't struggle with this one like I did the February block that had the long heart that I insisted I was going to accomplish. And for the most part, I did. If you're not familiar with this series, I will have a playlist link in the description of this video and also on the end screen. So this is the third block, and when I join this to the other two blocks that are already joined, let me get that and I'll show you. This is what we have so far. That was the first block, the second block. I don't want to move the pieces that I have on my board. So, and I joined them and we did ragging. So when we're done with the last block, we'll be almost done with the whole quilt. I'm going to tell you the sizes of the pieces you need. I'm going to do the specialty block with you. And then we'll definitely be doing all the hand quilting, the big stitch quilting off camera, because you saw me do it in the first one. And I do have a video on how to join. Maybe I'll jump in with a part two to wrap things up, but let me start here and get part one done. Our specialty block, I have the sample that I made. It's going to be a cute little house. And there are many, many houses, and I wasn't sure which one I wanted to do, so I just kind of made up my own. This is just the practice one. I used scraps. And I really do like it. I thought of using it for the quilt, but I have to make one on camera with you guys, so I have another one. I used the same dark blue star print for the roof, and I did still go with a red door, but it's going to be a light blue house. I have a white window, and this is the background. So I needed this so I can tell you, like, what things that you need to have be matchy-matchy. A lot of little pieces in this, but I think it's worth it. And that's going to go right here. I don't have the black border around it yet, obviously. So I'm going to give you the sizes of the pieces, and I've been asked to slow down when I say it. I think I kind of say it slow, maybe not. And I'm happy to slow down because it gives me a chance to make sure I'm saying the right things. Get a piece of paper and a pencil. Block A. And I always start with the width by the height. So block A is going to be 4.5 inches wide by 7.5 inches tall. B, 3.5 inches wide by 5 inches tall. C, 4 inches wide by 3.5 inches tall. D, 4 inches wide by 2 inches tall. E is right here, 4 inches wide by 5 inches tall. F, 3 inches wide by 2 inches tall. G, 2 inch square. H, 4.5 inches wide by 4 inches tall. I, we're going to trim our specialty block down to 9 inches wide by 8 inches tall. If you do not want to make the house, you don't have to. You're just going to cut a big piece like this, 9 inches wide by 8 inches tall. It's a good way sometimes to use up something that you have on a panel or just something pretty or a really big print. Okay, 9 by 8. J, right here, 2 inches wide, 6.5 tall. K, 2 inch square. I always like to tuck a few 2 inch squares in there because I love them. L, 5.5 inches wide by 2.5 inches tall. M, 2.5 inches square. 2.5 by 2.5. and N. 7.5 inches wide by 2.5 inches tall. And we are going to start by working on our specialty block, which we're going to do in just a minute. I will show you all the little pieces you need for that, so keep your pen and paper handy. Here's how we're going to do this. I know it looks complicated, lots of little pieces. We're going to tackle one section at a time. But first, I want to tell you what you need for colors. So I want you to know your house parts. I'm going to use my sample. And it happens that I liked the yellow around my house because it looked like a bright sunny day. But I found a smaller polka dot, so I think I'll like that better. And I used the same roof, and I still wanted a red door, but let's talk about that door. Well, first of all, it's a little bit crooked, a little wonky right there, and it's huge. I don't know why I made it so big. I thought it looked good on paper, but now I noticed that it's a big door. But we're going to have a big door, so when you move in and out of the house, you can put big furniture through that door. All right, so obviously, this is the door. So you want to pick a door color. This is the window. I went with white. This is the house color. All these little pieces that are blue. I'm going to have a blue house this time. The yellow is the background. And you need a color for your roof. I didn't bother with a chimney for this one. I thought a little window and a door was going to be enough. We're going to start with the roof, and you'll notice that I have two big squares of yellow because we're going to be snowballing. It's the easiest way to do it, and that's how I want to do it. And I'm going to give you the measurements of the pieces as we go, so I don't have to just spew out a bunch of numbers. So for the roof, you need a piece 5 inches wide by 3 inches tall, and for the background, you need 2 3-inch squares. So this is your background fabric. It's going to be on the roof like this. And that's it. Let's go to the machine. We have our three roof pieces. Again, this is 5 wide by 3 tall and 2 3-inch squares. Draw a line on the diagonal from corner to corner and lay it here. And I am going to sew on that line. And do you remember a little trick I taught you back in the crumb quilting adventure days? This is going to be trimmed off, this corner. And it's a pretty big piece. So what you can do is you can go and sew another line here. So you can see, the one that's corner to corner, that's my line that I needed to snowball. But then I drew another line here, and I'm going to just trim between those two lines. Not trim, I'm going to cut. I don't know what I'm talking about. And this will be pushed back and pressed. See how our roof is starting to look like it's pointed? And this is going to go in your crumb box. Because look at that. You made a nice little half square triangle. Isn't that sweet? It's a good way to sew those together. If you wait till after you trim them and try to put them together, it's not as easy. This was super easy. Now, you want to make sure that you do this the right way and don't accidentally sew this way. You want this to be your point of the roof, so you're going to sew in this direction. So make sure your diagonal line is going in this direction, and we're going to sew on that diagonal line. And I like to start at my corner, so I'm just going to turn it like this. And once again, let's save this half square triangle. So I'm going to sew another line on the outside of this line. Like that, and now I'm going to cut between those lines. And let me go press. I see that this little half square triangle, because of the way the the snowballs overlapped, and I do that on purpose because, see, we're going to have our point there no matter what. We're not going to lose our point. But again, that's okay because this can be for a crumb block. You could cut right here, cut that off and use that as an edge and just start adding fabric all around. So, crumb box. Our roof is done. Don't trim anything at this point. Put your roof down. Nice roof. Now we're going to work on this window, and we're not going to go to the machine together because this is just basic sewing. So I'm going to tell you the sizes of these pieces, and you're going to bring just these pieces to the sewing machine next. Your window itself is a 1.5 inch square. These two sides of the window, which is part of the house, so you want your house color. Everything here that I have blue is house color. So just, you know, make sure you know that you're working with house pieces there. This is 1 inch wide by 1.5 inches tall. Same here, 1 inch wide by 1.5 inches tall. And these two pieces are 2.5 inches wide by 1.5 inches tall. Same here, 2.5 inches wide by 1.5 inches tall. So start by putting these three pieces together. Put that back. And now we're going to sew these three pieces together. And it goes this way with the thicker pieces up and down and the narrow ones on the side. And I pressed, but I didn't trim yet. And this is, you know, an old house. That's why it's, you know, a little bit slanted maybe. That's okay. Now let's do the door. This, the actual door, is 2x3. And, you know, I would redesign it at some point and make that door a little smaller. But at this point, we're committed to 2x3. 2 wide by 3 tall. The house piece on top of the door is 2 inches wide by 1 inch tall. And this side piece, 1.5 inches wide by 3.5 inches tall. And remember, these blue are all house colors. I'm going to sew this to this, and then after I do that, this piece will fit, and we're going to sew it to this. I pressed, and this is what we have so far. Now, we're going to be sewing these pieces together. At this point, I'm going to trim just to make this a straight line. You're not aiming for, like, any inches, you know, I'm not going to say make sure it's 3 inches by whatever. I don't even know if that's what it should be. But I'm just saying, just make it be straight. And I'm not even going to touch this side because that's pretty straight. And then we're going to sew them together after you do that. Now we are ready to add the roof to the top of the house. So, oh my God, that's so cute. We're going to just make sure we have a straight line here. So I will trim the top of that. And this is good. So I'm just going to trim here and then sew these together. And again, I want to stress that we're just trimming enough to make it a straight line. I don't want you to think, I don't know how much to trim. Am I supposed to trim 1/4 inch or whatever? No, if it's straight, don't even trim. But if it's, you know, crooked or has, you know, some edges higher than others, just trim so that it's straight. Oh my God. I'm in love. I'm in love with houses now. We are almost done the house. We're going to put the two pieces of background there. Once again, we're going to just trim on each side to make a nice straight line, and then we're going to attach this. There's not any background on the bottom because we will add a black border around this and the house will just be sitting on that black border. So trim and sew those sides on. This is what we have. It's so cute. Now grab your 2-inch border, whatever color you're using. I'm using black throughout, and the only blocks that we are putting the black around are the little specialty blocks like the cat, the heart, and now the house. It doesn't matter, you know, what size your house came out to. Where's my ruler? Mine came out to about 6.5 by maybe 6, and we want it to be 9 by 8. When we add the border, add 2 inches. we'll be able to trim down to 9 by 8. And if your borders around the house are more narrow than the borders around the cat or whatever, doesn't matter. And it doesn't matter if, like, your top and bottom are, you know, not the same width as the sides. Again, doesn't matter. If you remember right, I had to add border to my heart because I screwed up. I had redesigned the heart and didn't go by my own rules. So I just take my whole strip. I like to start with the sides. I'm going to add black. And I don't cut in advance. I don't pre-cut the strip. I just sew. Well, let's show you. I sew like this. There's no right or wrong to this. And then when I get down to here, I just cut. And then I'll do this side. And then I'll do the top and bottom. I forgot to mention, trim the top and the bottom just so you get some nice straight lines. We are ready. We're going to replace this piece of paper with our house quilt block. Oh, I love it. I really do. I'm quite happy with the house. Now we're just going to start putting these pieces together. And there are a few ways that we have to attach certain things together. First, this bottom row has to be attached and added last because we gotta make these things fit to this first. So I'm going to start by sewing F and G together, and then I will attach H to that. I have that piece done, and now I'm going to attach A to this. Next, let's put C and D together. So I have that, and now I will attach B to this side and E to this side. Now let's put J and K together. Now we're going to attach L, M, and N like that. When I put this piece down, it wasn't matching up to my block, my house block. So I checked and I set it correctly. This was J and it is 2 inches wide by 6.5 inches tall, but I cut my piece 6 inches tall instead of 6.5. So I took the stitches out and I cut a new piece and I redid it. So I always check, and it's okay if you make a mistake. It was very easy to take that apart. Now we have a way to attach all of this. This is going on to the house first. The top goes on next, right here. This is coming out better than I thought. And this now, this side is going on this side of the house. Last but not least, we're going to add this piece to the bottom. And I can see I have a little tiny bit of a curve happening here. So I'm just going to go and straighten out that line and then I'll sew that together. This is what we have. I love it. I just love it. I want to do more houses and little towns. I'm always, you know, saying shit like that, and I never do it. But I really like the way this came out. And again, mine are coming out to about 14.5 inches. I don't bother trimming the edges at this point because it's going to be joined to my other pieces and snipped. So I don't care if things are not lined up perfectly. I do want to remind you, before you start cutting your pieces, because I didn't think of that the first time and I got lucky, this for me is going to be joined to the heart. And I remembered this time to look and make sure I didn't, you know, get matchy-matchy with the pieces here. Now, when we, you know, start doing the next row, then we're going to have to be concerned with what's touching this way and this way. So make sure you remember that. But I'm going to be stopping here for this one because I want to get this up and I do not have time to do the big stitch quilting. But I will come in with a part 2 to show you how it came out. And if I have anything else to tell you, I will at that point. I'll be doing the big stitch quilting and then I will be attaching it to my heart. So this is January, February, and March. The next one will be April 1st, the next quilt block. But like I said, you can look for part two soon, coming to a theater near you. I don't know, remember that? I hope you enjoyed this. I think the block, a lot of little pieces, but it's very easy to put together, and I like it, even though it's got a giant door. Thank you so much for watching. I'll be back with more soon. Bye!